Miss Frye, what a pleasant surprise.
Hello, Clara. I was just going to check on Lambeth since the asylum's closing. What brings you here?
The children in my care have been falling ill. Our usual tonics aren't working. I came to...
Are you certain you're feeling all right?
Of course. I am, miss.
Clara! Is there a doctor nearby?
Bring her inside. She simply collapsed?
Yes, she said the others took tonic, but it didn't work.
I should think not. Ever since Elliotson was murdered, the district has been overrun with counterfeit tonics. This one needs proper care. But without the appropriate medication, she and the others will quickly decline.
What do you need?
I need supplies. Plenty of them. And medicine. Some of the less common ingredients are being stolen and sold at auction.
I'd be happy to help.
Here's the list. Miss...
Frye. Evie Frye.
I'm Miss Nightingale. How do you do? Please hurry. We don't have much time.
Come on. I can't thank you enough. These supplies are meant for Miss Nightingale.
I'm here to collect them.
They're already loaded on the cart. Please take them.
Giddy up!
You mean that cart?
Yes.
Of course it is.
Please be careful. Some of those items are fragile.
Faster! Here now.
Not a moment too soon. I hope you brought the medication I requested.
How is she?
She will recover.
Babylon Alley, the children.
Thanks to you, we can distribute authentic medicine now.
But is that a permanent solution?
I will petition to have regulations put in place.
Lambeth is in your debt.
It takes a long time to change things. But I'm not going anywhere, Miss Frye.
Jacob, darling, do join me.
To our fruitful partnership.
And to the shiny new engines now in my possession. Back to business. Milner's fled to the Thames, occupied with securing his ferry. It's all he has left.
Protecting it with his life, no doubt.
The very thing I want you to take. Just kill him.
That's not your first glass of champagne, is it?
Success is more intoxicating than alcohol, Mr. Frye.
Then save a glass for me.
Now, what would it take to draw out Starek's pawn? The sight of his ferries in flames, perhaps?
Now to sink Milner's enterprise.
What the bloody hell? I lost the engines. So this is my comeuppance.
Pearl Attaway led me to you, not Starrick.
And then we're gonna gather again. I should never have come between Mr. Starrick and Miss Attaway. Family always stay together in the end.
What do you mean, they're family?
Time for Pearl and I to have a real conversation. There you are. What are you up to now, Pearl?
Get out of here now! I was certain he knew that I belonged to the Order and was there to end me. Imagine my delight when he told me his true purpose. An assassin helping the Templar cause. Isn't that delicious?
It's sick.
It's business.
You glower too much, cousin. You will get your engines back. Our new motorized buses will bring us both a lot of money.
I'll need to arrange proper transport for the engines to get back to my factory. I want you at Waterloo, personally, to ensure that nothing goes wrong.
Of course. May the Father of Understanding guide us.
Today and in all of our future endeavors, cousin. Waterloo Station.
Door's jammed.
Again? Just give it a shove.
I see someone! He's right there!
Thank goodness you're here. Impossible as it may sound, Spring-Heeled Jack has returned. we need to do something before the unthinkable happens.
I thought we'd already dealt with this nonsense.
There may be more to this than we originally thought.
Anything of interest?
Just that the Bobby's choked off a group of protesters in Hyde Park. Well, that's what happens when you speak up.
Get away from me, you monster!
You there! Stop what you're doing!
I am a ghost, not a fiend. A terror is a knight. I am the terror of London. I am a ghost, performing the deeds of a devil upon the earth. You have been forged by man in harm. Long have I stalked the streets of London! No one is safe from my beastly claws!
Let's have a salvo!
I am a ghost! A fiend! A terror in the night!
Well, thanks to you, the Ghost Club's reputation has grown tremendously. We are a beacon of reason in a world beguiled by superstition.
But I believe we have encountered one genuine spirit.
Can you be certain? That's the question. One might surmise that the spirits that haunt us are simply our deepest fears, manifested as apparitions.
Shame. I've always wanted to see a ghost or a goblin.
I propose a toast to the Ghost Club and the virtuous twins that have aided it, Miss Evie and Mr. Jacob. Cheers.